Wow, a tough act to follow there, but certainly good morning. Thank you all for coming out today. As we discuss, and I'm going to use a little different term than retirement, I'm going to use the term transition as we discuss the transition of Coach Larry Blakeney, because certainly as you all heard just a few of the stories there, the guy's a legend. You know, you don't use that term very loosely, but he certainly is a legend and synonymous with Troy football and the success that it's had over the last 24 years. I want to give Dr. Hawkins regards. He regrets the fact he is not able to be here today, but he actually had a commitment, is being honored at a luncheon today in Birmingham with the Alabama Humanities Foundation, and certainly sends his regards and certainly expresses the thanks for Coach Larry Blakeney. And again, I want to start out today talking about a thank you for everything that Coach Larry Blakeney has meant to this program. You know, you talk about the 175 wins, 5 Sun Belt titles, 5 bowl appearances, during the 1AA days, 7 out of 8 years in the playoffs. And you can go on and on and on, and the numbers don't lie in terms of his success on the football field. But to me, and to many of you, the greater thing that Coach Larry Blakeney has brought to Troy football is the development of young men, and not developing them on the football field, because certainly you look at his number of NFL guys and the guys that have had success in the Canadian Football League. He's done a tremendous job of that on the field, but you look off the field, because really what the business we're in is preparing young men and young women, our student athletes, for the game of life. And you look at what he's done in terms of developing those young men in the game of life and the success stories across all different walks of life. To me, that is the number one thing that Larry Blakeney has accomplished, and certainly we are very thankful for that. You know, certainly a lot of that success, and we talk, you all have heard me talk about the Troy family, and certainly one of the things that really makes this place so special is the family feel. And certainly Larry Blakeney has done that, and it starts at home with Janice, his wife, and their daughters, and as he talked about, his son-in-laws and grandchildren. Family is number one, first and foremost to him, not just his blood family, but certainly when you look at the assistant coaches and the lineage of successful coaches he's had. And you know, we have a tremendous staff of assistant coaches here right now, but all of those, along with his players and anybody in the Troy Athletics or the Troy University family, have all been truly family to him and will continue to be. And again, I go back to the term, not retirement, but transition, because, you know, although he may be stepping away at the end of the year as our head football coach, he will continue to play an important role in Troy Athletics. Certainly, I would be remiss if I didn't talk about also, you know, what he has accomplished and what he has done is far-reaching. It goes way beyond Troy football or Troy athletics or Troy University or the city of Troy. I know Mayor Lunsford is in here, and certainly if you reflect back on what Larry Blakeney has done for this community in terms of exposure and development and everything else, you know, a huge gratitude is to go there as well. Let's shift gears a little bit about the remainder of the season. And certainly, you know, Coach Blakeney did a tremendous job with our 130 or so young men that were in here in the meeting last night. And as he said, he spent about 30 minutes with those guys. And as I looked around the room, you had eyes locked in and focused. And again, just a testament to the power and what he means to these young men. We're very excited, and I speak on behalf of our athletic department. Certainly, I've visited with many of the assistant coaches. We're very excited about the remainder of this season. Is 0-5 where any of us expected to be or want to be? No, absolutely not. But I can promise you, as I look back here and see a lot of our football staff in this room, those guys are busting their tails every day, every night, and yesterday's announcement made no change. I got here about 10 minutes to 5 this morning to get an early morning workout before the day got going, and I see some of our assistants' cars already here. You think about that. Guys find out that, hey, you know, there's going to be a coaching transition, so certainly there's some anxiety amongst those guys. But again, it talks about the work ethic that Larry Blakeney has not only for himself, but he's instilled in his assistants, and certainly we're appreciative of that. And for that, we're very optimistic about the remainder of our season. You know, 7 regular season games left to play, and you look down that schedule, there's not a game that our coaching staff and our young men don't believe we can't win. And certainly there's the opportunity to run the table on that. So we're looking forward to getting that started Saturday against New Mexico State. You know, I know the question, I think it came from Drew, whether it was prompted by somebody else or not, came about the timing. And certainly as Larry and I were in discussions and Dr. Hawkins was involved in those discussions as well, you say, hey, you know, what's the significance of mid-year, and does that make sense? Does it not make sense? As we talked through it, it made more and more sense. And again, this is not about Larry Blakeney getting up and walking away from Troy University. It's about him transitioning from being the head coach that he's been for 24 years. And let me caveat that by saying, not only has he been the head coach, he's been a tremendous ambassador for our university in all aspects. And our intention as he transitions is going to continue to be an ambassador. It may just be a little different. It may be on the golf course or a dove shoot or something like that, where we can utilize him to engage with donors and potential donors, as opposed to being the head football coach on the sideline. But we're excited about that. We thought, and believe that this could give a definite jump start to the remainder of our season, and certainly as we look at transition, give us the opportunity to get out ahead of the curve, if you will, in terms of starting the process about looking to see, like Larry talked about, who's the right fit for the next head coach of Troy University football. I'll just touch basically again as well on Larry's role. His title, if you will be special assistant to the athletic director. We will utilize him in some fundraising opportunities, and certainly first and foremost above that, again reflecting back to what he said about facilities, relates to that north end zone. We're getting closer every day to that north end zone, but I can tell you that north end zone is getting ready to happen, and certainly appreciative for the support that Dr. Hawkins and our university administration is going to give us a jump start to get that thing going. And so we're re-engaging architects and trying to get that thing up out of the ground here just as soon as possible. I'll touch briefly on the search process. Certainly that will begin immediately. Again, our focus is on winning these last 7 regular season games, and if we're successful in 6 or 7 of those, certainly a bowl game, which we think is very attainable. But we will go ahead and begin the search. I can promise you, just as Larry said, his phone has been going off since last night. All of a sudden, I have a whole bunch of new best friends who say, hey, I've got so-and-so that's interested, or so-and-so. But all that being said, joking aside, I think the interest in it, again, speaks volumes to the foundation that Coach Larry Blakeney has established or has continued in our program. And again, if you look last night, after that release went out roughly 8 o'clock last night, Adam, is that correct? You look at the national media, you look at the different things on Twitter and Facebook and different websites, and the positive things that were said about Coach Larry Blakeney and what he's done at Troy University. Again, tremendous gratitude goes to him and just speaks volumes about the respect he has amongst his peers and in the industry as well. But again, on the search, we'll have an advisory committee. It won't be a search committee, but we will have an advisory committee for the position, certainly made up of a variety of folks, including some former players stretching across several decades, and folks, some local folks, some business leaders, folks who are familiar with our situation. And again, we believe we are going to have already had and will continue to have tremendous interest in the job. You know, in turn, I know you guys are going to ask the question about what's your timetable. You know, ideally, we would love to have somebody selected by December 1st. Is that reasonable? Maybe not, but certainly by December 15th, because at the end of the day, and again, referring back to something Larry had to say, you know, it's about players, and certainly the lifeblood of getting players is recruiting, and we understand that, you know, the sooner we have definition towards the future of our program, that will assist us in recruiting. But again, just in closing, and I'll open it up to some questions here in a few minutes, just so appreciative for what Coach Larry Blakeney has done over the last 24 years, again, for Troy University, for Troy football, for the state of Alabama. We're excited about the remaining seven regular season games. We know the staff and our players are going to be fully engaged towards winning, which is all going to start at 2 o'clock on Saturday against New Mexico State for homecoming. And then certainly as we look forward beyond this year to the future of Troy football, you look at the rich, rich history that has been established by so many folks over the years, and certainly the last 24 years cornerstoned by Coach Larry Blakeney. We believe that foundation is rock solid, and that the next person that we select to guide this program and our young men involved in our football program, that the sky is the limit for the future of Troy football. Thank you all so much, and I'll open it up to questions now. Well, first of all, and certainly just in what we've received in the last, you know, 12, 14 hours, the interest in our position is going to be extreme in a very positive way. There are going to be a lot of very qualified candidates, and what our job is, again, it goes back to fit, finding the right person in terms of Troy University, Troy football, stands for ideals, has the core values of hard work and integrity and wanting to be the very best that we can be, and will outwork all of our competition, whether it's on the recruiting trail, in the game preparation trail, everything about it. But all of those things are going to be taken into consideration, and certainly we'll evaluate all of those candidates, probably at some point narrow it down to three or four who appear to be the very best fits, and then you know, make a selection from that group.
Another one of the concerns, especially at schools this size, is the financial aspects of things. What do you think boys answer in that regard?
You know, certainly as you look at the escalating cost of college athletics, you know, and you guys all know this because you all do FOI requests. I mean, Larry's salary, $505 a year, which puts us about average right now in the Sun Belt Conference. You know, we span from Mark Hudspeth at Lafayette, he's making seven figures a year now, all the way down. I think the lowest head coach in our league is around $300,000. So we certainly are prepared to be as competitive as we need to be, both in terms of head coaching salary and assistance pool. And, you know, there are other things involved with that include facilities, And you know, I'm so fortunate because having the support and buy-in from, you know, from Dr. Hawkins and our entire administration. Again, football is what drives the train here. We all know that. You know, you look at the success some of our fall programs have had. Our soccer team, tremendous year so far, 10-3. But what gets the headlines, what has all you guys aren't lined up to come to our soccer matches. You guys are interested in the engine that drives the train is football, and we're prepared to provide the financial resources necessary for us to be successful.
A lot of times you see current coaching changes, the process kind of happens while around bowl season. Is there any rules and stipulations you have to follow in terms of contacting maybe other coaches or current assistants?
You know, certainly so, and we will have full respect, you know, in terms of the interest level or reaching out to, and in a lot of cases, folks will reach out to us. But certainly, you know, if we were in a situation where somebody were trying to have an interest in one of our coaches, I don't think it would be right to interfere a season that's going on. Now, if a head coach, you know, let's just use the example of maybe it's a coordinator somewhere. If the head coach reaches out to me or the athletic director reaches out to me and says, hey, John, so-and-so is interested in your position, and I don't have a problem with you talking to them, you know, certainly we would look at that. But I don't want us, I wouldn't want it happening to us, so I don't want to compromise, you know, anybody's season or disrupt anybody's season by reaching out to somebody involved. And that goes back to our timetable. You know, it ideally, I'd love to have somebody on board by December 1st, but it may be in terms of official communication or anything like that, we may have to wait till after the regular season is over for some folks.
Does it matter if Coach Meyer has head coaching experience?
You know, Drew, I'm not going to get caught up in that, or we're not going to get caught up in that. Again, it has to be the right fit. But, you know, you can take all kinds of examples of guys who had never been head coaches before, who stepped into major college head coaching positions, who have been successful, and then you can take the flip of that. Some guys who had been head coaches at some level before who stepped into it and weren't successful. So, again, I think as we analyze what they've done career-wise, you know, certainly having something that's unique because, you know, we don't have all the resources that Tuscaloosa or Auburn does. So you got to think outside the box a little bit, whether you're an administrator, whether you're a football coach or anything else. And I kind of like, you know, somebody who hasn't always been someplace where they've had endless resources to be successful, somebody who can think outside the box a little bit. But again, we're not going to narrow the field by saying you have to have been a head coach or you have to have been a coordinator or anything like that. Again, back to not narrowing the field. Ideally, you know, would we like somebody to come and be able to stay for 20 plus years like Larry? Absolutely. But I don't think we want to narrow the field by saying, well, gosh, this guy, you know, this guy is a, quote, rising star in the profession, and, you know, he may come to Troy for 3 or 4 years and move on to somewhere. If that happens and our program is here and that person can come in for 3 or 4 years and elevate us to this level, I don't, you know, again, I'd like continuity for a long period of time, but I'm not going to have heartache about looking at somebody who can elevate our program over a 3 or 4 year period and leave it, you know, at a better position than they inherited it. Say that again. You know, certainly those guys are here through the end of the season, which hopefully is through the end of a bowl, either in December or early January, and you know, we'll go through the process not to interfere with game week preparation or anything, but certainly look at where we stand right now recruiting wise, and you know. Coach Randy Butler, who's our recruiting coordinator, and Jamal Smith, who's heavily involved with recruiting, will continue to work through that, and certainly want to continue to provide exposure of our program to folks, certainly on Saturday home games. We'll continue to have unofficial and some official visits here. So our current staff will be engaged in that.
Thank